Hi, I'm Ivy Elkins, and I am a lung cancer patient and advocate. And I am here with Dr. David Carbone today, and we are going to talk about biomarkers through Hope with Answers. So my first question for you, Dr. Carbone, is I hear a lot about biomarkers. Could you start out by telling me what is a biomarker?
Well, a biomarker is just a feature of a cancer that we can test in the laboratory to help us pick the best treatment for each person's cancer. And as we learn more and more about the different types of cancers and the different subsets of cancers, each is sensitive to different approaches, and we have to characterize the cancer beyond just telling us whether it's cancer or not cancer. And those are biomarkers.
Are there some biomarkers that patients might have heard of before?
Well, patients might have heard of EGFR as a biomarker. Mm-hmm. That stands for epidermal growth factor receptor. That was one of the first important ones discovered and still is a crucial biomarker to test for in what's called non-squamous, non-small cell lung cancer.
Now, what's non-squamous? Non-small cell lung cancer. See, it's a mouthful. I can't even get it out.
Well, lung cancer is divided into types. There's small cell and non-small cell. And then within non-small cell, the two major categories are squamous and adenocarcinoma. And those are types of non-small cell lung cancer. And most of the gene mutations we were talking about are in non-squamous or the adenocarcinoma part of non-small cell.
Okay.
That really refers to how the tumor looks under a microscope. And it's kind of an old-fashioned way of telling one tumor from another. And we know of much more specific and much more therapeutically impactful differences now through the marker testing.
Okay, I understand. Should all patients be tested for biomarkers?
Nowadays, I would say all patients, both squamous and non-squamous, should be tested for some biomarkers. Different ones for different subsets of tumors and for different patients. But I think that's a discussion that you should have with your doctor about the importance of getting a complete panel of testing done and doing it before any treatment is initiated.
Thank you so much, Dr. Carbone. This has been very helpful. Thanks for joining us with
You're
Hope
welcome.
With Answers.